Hi, and welcome to my chess channel. My name is Martin, and today I'm going to continue on my series on the London system. And in the last episode, I looked at the Wei Yi game by the Chinese Super GM, and he has played some really nice games in the London system. And some of them he has played the against system where black plays c5, challenging white center. He played knight d2, which is not the normal move. The normal move is c3. So I've been looking into this move, and he has had some really nice results with it. So I'm trying to find out, why is this so good, and is it good? And how does we win with this? So, in the last game, we looked at the variation knight c6, d3, and then Alexandrov played queen to b6, and here we replied queen to c2. If you want to see this, go back to the go to the playlist and find this game. But this game today, I'm going to look at between Wei Yi and Vladimir Malakhov. And Malakhov is a very strong Russian grandmaster. And in this rabbit game, Malakhov replied not knight c6, but he replied c takes d4. So here, Wei Yi, he took the d-pawn, and Malakhov played bishop to d4, threatening the white queen. And we blocked with his knight, and see the knight on d2 helps protect the knight, so there's no immediate danger. Knight c6. And now we can see that the d4 pawn is threatened because of the pin. And we defended with c3. And black replied e6. Queen b3 attacking the b7 pawn. And queen to c8 defending the pawn. We developed this bishop to the d-file, and it's quite normal place to move the bishop in the London system behind the pawn chain, and it's normally really good on this diagonal. So Malakhov played bishop to e7, delivering his bishop, and now we castled, and black castles as well. So, what can white do here? And in the London system, this move is a very normal move, and we played knight to e5, and it's very normal to get your knight into the center, and here you also attack the bishop on g4. So black either has to take or move the bishop away. And here you look at the variation. If they play bishop to h5, then white can continue with the knight to f3 and protecting his knight in the center. Black can continue knight to e4, and here white probably best advice to place queen back to c2 and put a threat to the knight. And here black can take e5, bishop takes, and now black can defend this knight with f5. This is not the only moves, but just an example of how the game could have continued. Knight d2, attacking the knight again. And six, takes, takes, and f3. And now knight to d6. And you can see that now this pawn is a potential weakness for black. And the rooks are ready to occupy the open line. So in the game, Malakhov took with the knight, and Wei took back with the bishop, and Malakhov played knight back to attack the bishop in the center, and Wei calmly played the bishop back to f4. But he didn't want to exchange his bishop, which makes sense. So Malakhov played knight to b6. And now it stops the threat against the b7 pawn. So Wei Yi played a4, maybe threatening a5. And Malakhov played bishop to f5. Posing exchange of the bishops. I think this is a mistake by Malakhov, because it gives black a weakness in its pawn structure when white recaptures. Probably better is to play the knight to d7. Black does not get this weakness in his pawn structure, but still think that white's pieces are better placed in. Bishop to f5, takes, and now you can see that there's a potential outpost for this knight, and it can jump into these positions, and the bishop can help protect. So I think white here has the chief's position. Rook to e1, queen e7, protecting the bishop. Now a5, pushing the knight away. Knight back to c8. Now the plan of getting knight into the center, knight f3, f6, stopping that idea. But on the downside, that opens up the direction for the king. And c4, trying to undermine the center directly, and opening up the new weakness in black's position. And now rook to e8, and now another really nice move, a6, trying to damage black's pawn structure even more. And Malakhov did not want to open the a file, so he played b6, and now again trying to destroy the pawn structure, and by playing c5. Now Malakhov desperately tries to get some counterplay by playing g5, but Wei plays the cool c6, attacking the queen, and queen takes, and now rook to c1, queen again, and queen back, and now the bishop can move into the c file. So bishop to c7, rook to d7, attacking the bishop, and queen to b5, and pinning the queen. So bishop taking, also by the rook. And this pawn is a weakness for black, because the check and this so this rook is is doing a lot of jobs and can that this can be exploited. And Malakhov tried to defend with a knight to d6, but now the pawn is not protected, and we played the queen to takes e5, king to g7, takes, and you say, takes, and you can see that takes, queen takes here, could be winning. Let me just check it, like, I got this correct. Yeah. And the game finished with the queen to e6. And if black takes, queen takes here, and the white rooks is simply dominating the seventh rank. So a really nice game by Wei Yi, again showing that this move knight d2 can be an attractive choice against an early five by black against the London system. In the next video I will look at a third Wei Yi game in this system. So if you want to follow, please subscribe, and I will bring more videos about the London system, but also other videos. I have another playlist on questions of modern chess theory, and I also think about bringing some game analysis of my own games in the future. So stay tuned. Bye.